فَلَوْلَا نَفَرَ مِنْ كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِنْهُمْ طَائِفَةٌ لِيَتَفَقَّهُوا فِي الدِّينِ.
لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح.
إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين. All praise are due to Allah. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His assistance and forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil of ourselves. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil of ourselves and from the consequences of our evil deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can misguide, and whomsoever is allowed to go astray, none can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was his servant and messenger. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة. As for what follows, the most truthful of speech is that of Allah, and the best of examples is the example of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the worst of affairs are innovations in worship. Every innovated form of worship is a misguidance, and every misguidance is a cause for Allah's punishment. May Allah protect us and prevent us from being punished eternally. أيها المؤمنون عباد الله، يقول ربنا تبارك وتعالى عن عبده لقمان الحكيم حينما وعظ ابنه ونصحه ووصاه، قال عنه أنه قال: يا بني إنها إن تك مثقال حبة من خردل فتكن في صخرة أو في السماوات أو في الأرض يأتي بها الله. إن الله لطيف خبير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about his humble servant, obedient servant, his wise and knowledgeable servant, Luqman the wise. When Luqman advised his son, reminded his son, and told his son, "O my son, O my dear son, if it is the weight of a mustard seed," meaning the tyranny that you may commit or the sin that you may commit, no matter how small it may be. And Allah Azza wa Jalla uses the size of a mustard seed, which is quite small in size. Now, this mustard seed, if it is put or placed inside of a boulder, meaning to conceal it, or inside of anything that can be used to conceal a mustard seed, or if it's put in the heavens somewhere to be concealed, or if it's placed in the earth somewhere to be concealed, يأتي بها الله. Allah will bring it forth, meaning يوم القيامة, on the day of Qiyamah, on the day of resurrection, on the day of judgment, on the day of recompense, on the day that all actions will be brought forth, on the day that even our skin will testify for us or against us. Allah Azza wa Jalla will bring it forth. Indeed, Allah is subtle and aware. عباد الله إنه ما من شر وداء في الدنيا والآخرة إلا وسببه الذنوب والمعاصي. There isn't any form of illness or evil in this life or in the hereafter except it is caused by sins. Any evil is caused by sins. تأمل إخوتي في الله تأملوا كتاب ربنا عز وجل حين قص علينا ما حل بالأمم السابقة من أنواع العقوبات جزاء معصية الله ومخالفة أمره. Look at what Allah عز وجل tells us about the previous people who've come before us and how they were destroyed because of their sins. تأمل ما الذي أخرج الوالدين الكريمين آدم وحواء من الجنة دار اللذة والنعيم إلى دار الآلام والأحزان. What caused Adam and Hawa to be expelled from Jannah? What caused them to be expelled from Jannah? تأمل ما الذي أخرج إبليس من ملكوت السماء وطرده ولعنه ومسخ ظاهره وباطنه وبدله بالقرب بعدا وبالرحمة لعنة وبالجنة نارا فهان على الله غاية الهوان وحل عليه غضب الرب فمقته أكبر المقت كل هذا بمخالفة أمر الله وارتكاب نهيه. Look at Iblis. How he was close and endeared to Allah Azza wa Jalla, an obedient servant. And then that turned on its head when he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he turned from being or having mercy on him to being cursed. And from being close to being far, and from being from the people of Jannah to the people of Nar. Na'udhu billah. وتأمل تأمل حال الأمم المخالفة لرسلها كيف كان عذاب الله بها شديدا And look at the peoples who disobeyed their messengers and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. انظر ما حل بقوم نوح من الغرق فكذبوه فأنجيناه والذين معه في الفلك وأغرقنا الذين كذبوا بآياتنا إنهم كانوا قوما عمين. The people of Nuh, Noah alayhi salam, how Allah azza wa jal caused them to drown. They disobeyed, they disbelieved in him, so Allah azza wa jal caused them to drown, all of them except for those who believed in Allah azza wa jal. Allah saved them in the boat or in the safina. وانظر ما حل بفرعون وقومه حين كذبوا وكذا ما حل ببني إسرائيل. Look at what happened to Fir'aun and his people after they saw all of the signs, they decided to still disbelieve. Allah Azza wa Jalla destroyed them. وهكذا تتوالى نذر الله على عباده الذين خالفوا أمره بأنواع العقوبات. And likewise, those who disobey Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah sends upon them all types of calamities, all types of destruction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. All of them we've taken because of their sin. بِذَنْبِهِ. فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. We've taken them all, destroyed them all, because of their sin, because of their dhanb. مَا أَهْوَنَ الْخَلْقِ عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا أَهْوَنَ الْخَلْقِ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِذَا هُمْ خَالَفُوا أَمْرَهِ فَكَمْ أَهْلَكَ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ بِسَبَبِ عِصْيَانِهِمْ وَتَكْذِيبِهِمْ. How little do we become in the eyesight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How humiliated do we become in the eyesight of Allah Azza wa Jal when we disobey Him? Allah honors us when we obey Him. He takes us to the heights of spirituality, the heights of goodness, the heights of success when we are obedient to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. But He takes us to the lowest of the low when we are disobedient. لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, we've created mankind in the best of forms and then we brought him down to the lowest of the low. نعوذ بالله. أيها المؤمنون, المعاصي سبب كل عناء وطريق كل شقاء فما حلت بديار إلا أهلكتها ولا فشت في مجتمعات إلا دمرتها وما هلك من هلك إلا بالذنوب وما نجا من نجا بعد رحمة الله إلا بالطاعة والتوبة. Believers, my brothers and sisters, so many tribes, so many cities have been destroyed because of sin. Sins are the cause of every calamity. Sins, when they become widespread in a place, they are the cause of its destruction. It never spreads in an area except it completely destroys it. And those who are destroyed, they're destroyed because of their sin. And those who are saved, they are saved because of tawbah, repentance to Allah Azza wa Jal. وَإِنَّمَا يُصِيبُ النَّاسَ مِنْ ضُرٍّ وَضِيقٍ فِي أَبْدَانِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ وَأَرْزَاقِهِمْ وَأَوْطَانِهِمْ إِنَّمَا هُوَ بِسَبَبِ مَعَاصِيهِمْ وَمَا كَسَبَتْهُ أَيْدِيهِمْ. قَالَ تَعَالَى وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُو عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. مِنْ هُنَا لِلتَّوْكِيدِ يعني كل مصيبة أصابتك يا ابن آدم فهي بسبب ذنبك ولكن ربنا تبارك وتعالى من رحمته ولطفه ورأفته سبحانه وتعالى يعفو عن كثير، فلا يؤاخذنا بجميع ذنوبنا. قال تعالى: ولو يؤاخذ الله الناس بما كسبوا ما ترك على ظهرها من دابة ولكن يؤخرهم إلى أجل مسمى. Every calamity, every bad thing that befalls us, every time we go through hardship, it is because of our sin. Whether it's hardship within ourselves or in our wealth or within our children or in our societies, it's because of our sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, any calamity that befalls you is because of your sin. Yet Allah pardons much. Any calamity that befalls you is because of your sin. But Allah pardons much, meaning had Allah Azza wa Jal held us accountable for every last mishap, our lives would be in shambles. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another ayah, had Allah held us accountable or taken us for everything that we've done, He would not leave on the face of the earth any soul. However, He delays our judgment, our reckoning, to a time that has been spelled out. عفاني الله وإياكم من الذنوب والمعاصي ومن آثارها. فمن آثار الذنوب والمعاصي، نعوذ بالله، حرمان العلم، فهو نور يقذفه الله في القلب والمعصية تطفئه. قال مالك ابن أنس رحمه الله للشافعي حينما رأى فطنته وذكاءه: إني أرى الله قد ألقى على قلبك نورا فلا تطفئه بظلمة المعصية. Of the consequences of sin is that knowledge, the light of knowledge, is taken away. Because knowledge is a light that Allah places in your heart, and the sin puts out that light. Malik ibn Anas rahimahullah said to Imam al-Shafi'i, once he saw that he was highly intelligent and witty, he said to him, I see that Allah has put in your heart the light of knowledge, so do not put it out. Do not put out that light by committing sin. ومن الآثار حرمان الرزق كما قال في الأثر إن العبد لا يحرم الرزق بالذنب يصيبه. Another of the consequences of sin is that provisions are taken away from you. Your wealth is taken away, as many scholars have mentioned. ومنها وحشة يجدها العاصي في قلبه بينه وبين الله عز وجل وبينه وبين الناس، وكلما قويت هذه الوحشة بعد عن مجالسة أهل الخير وقرب من حزب الشيطان وأهله. Another of the consequences of sin is a sort of loneliness that the sinner finds in his heart. This loneliness, he finds a detachment between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he finds a detachment between him and others as well. And the stronger this detachment or loneliness grows, he becomes farther and farther away from the people of good, from the people of Allah Azza wa Jal, and he comes nearer and nearer to the team of the shaytan and the team of sinners. نعوذ بالله من ذلك. ومنها تعسير الأمور، فكما أن من يتق الله عز وجل يجعل الله له من أمره يسرا، فبخلافه من عصى الله عز وجل. ف فمن عصى الله عز وجل جعل الله من أمره عسرا. نعوذ بالله. Another of the consequences of sin is that you find difficulty in attaining or reaching your goals. You want to do something or accomplish something, but something is stopping you. You're not able to. Look at your relationship with Allah. Look at the sins that you are committing, that you are indulged in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whomsoever has taqwa, Allah will make his affairs facilitated and easy. However, if someone is disobedient to Allah Azza wa Jalla and is heedless, Allah Azza wa Jalla makes his affairs difficult. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Ikhwati fi Allah, أقول ما قلت وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وأصلي وأسلم على خير خلق الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أيها المسلمون، فكما أن الذنوب والمعاصي لها آثار وخيمة على الفرد، فلها آثار سيئة على المجتمعات كلها. فمن تلكم الآثار قال تعالى: فلما نسوا ما ذكروا به فتحنا عليهم أبواب كل شيء حتى إذا فرحوا بما أوتوا أخذناهم بغتة فإذا هم مبلسون. فيأتي الهلاك لمجتمعات بأكملها بسبب ذنوبها ومعاصيها. The same way there are consequences on a person individually of sin, there are also consequences on the entire society. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when they forgot what they were reminded of, we opened the doors of this dunya for them. And then when the time came for them to be destroyed, they were destroyed altogether. Na'udhu billah. ومن آثار هذه الذنوب على المجتمعات أن الذنوب تزيل النعم. قال تعالى: ضرب الله مثلا قرية كانت آمنة مطمئنة يأتيها رزقها رغدا من كل مكان فكفرت بأنعم الله فأذاقها الله لباس الجوع والخوف بما كانوا يصنعون. أزال الله النعم بسبب ذنوبها ومعاصيها. Another of the consequences that happens to societies because of sin is that Allah Azza wa Jalla takes away the provisions that they may have had. أخرج البخاري ومسلم من حديث أبي قتادة أنه مر على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بجنازة فقال: مستريح ومستراح منه. قالوا: يا رسول الله، ما المستريح وما المستراح منه؟ فقال: العبد المؤمن يستريح من نصب الدنيا، والعبد الفاجر يستريح منه العباد والبلاد والشجر والدواب. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saw a janazah, person who had passed away passing by him. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, he is rested or rested from. So the Sahaba, they asked him, what do you mean, Ya Rasulullah, rested and rested from? He said, if he is a believer, then he has rested from the difficulties of this dunya. But if he is a disbeliever, or if he's a sinner, then the people have rested from him. The land has rested from him. And even the animals and cattle have rested from his mischief. نعوذ بالله. عباد الله. ومما يسبب أو ينشر البلاء في البلاد وبين الناس الابتعاد عن الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر والمجاهرة بالمعاصي. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: كل أمتي معافا إلا المجاهرون. كل أمتي معافا إلا المجاهرون. يذنب العبد بينه وبين ربه فيتوب ويتوب الله عليه، لكن يذنب أمام الناس فيرى الناس ذنبه، فيرى ضعاف القلوب هذا الذنب فيريدون مجاورة هذا المذنب، فبدلا من أن يكسب ذنبا بينه وبين الله عز وجل يكسب سيئتين، سيئة بحيث أنه هو الذي يذنب، والسيئة الثانية أنه دل على ضلالة، فكان دالا على ضلالة، كل من تعلم أو دل على هذه الضلالة فله وزرها ووزر من عمل بها، نعوذ بالله. Among the things that cause sins to become widespread is to be open about your sin and to refrain from reminding people to discontinue sinning. A person would commit a sin between him and Allah Azza wa Jalla, nobody is around, and they ask Allah to forgive them and Allah forgives them. That's one sin. However, a person may commit a sin in the open where others can see, and he's saying, oh, I don't want to be a munafiq. This is his argument. So that's why I do it in front of people. I don't want to hide. I want to show people who I really am. But what happens is others see you committing that sin, and they say, oh, it's not so bad. Maybe I'll do that too. And now you have the sin of you committing it and the sin of encouraging others to commit it. And the more people are encouraged by that person that you encouraged, the more sin that you have. نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. قال الله تعالى فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ أَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ السُّوءِ وَأَخَذْنَا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا بِعَذَابٍ بَئِيسٍ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. When they forgot what they were reminded of, speaking of the people of Saturday, they were fishing on, they would put their nets out on Friday and collect the fish on Sunday because they were prohibited from fishing on Saturday. So there were a group of them who told them, stop doing this, this is a disobedience. You're trying to trick Allah Azza wa Jalla, but Allah cannot be tricked. And there were others from among them who didn't do anything and didn't say anything. Three groups. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He saved the ones who used to remind others, don't do this. In our society nowadays, there are many sins that are widespread. But one that has become in our face, it has been pushed on us, is the sin of Qawm Lut. And on top of that, the sin of changing Allah's creation. You don't know who's a male or female anymore. And on top of that, what's even worse is the encouragement of this sin. Encouraging people to indulge in this sin. Even if they had no idea about what this sin is, now because it's become widespread, there are others, there are people that are thinking about it. Na'udhu billah. And it's become justified as if it's normal. The least we can do is speak out about how bad this is in the eyesight of Allah Azza wa Jal, how despicable this is in the eyesight of Allah Azza wa Jal, how much harm this causes to the society as a whole, how this breaks up families, how this brings about the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remind people. Don't be happy with the widespread of sin. قال الشاعر لا تحقرن من الذنوب صغيرة إن الصغيرة غدا يعود كبيرة إن الصغيرة ولو تقادم عهده عند الإله مسطر تسطيرا. The poet said, do not belittle any small sin. A small sin tomorrow turns into a major sin. A sin, even if it becomes old and old and old, it is still written with Allah, and He will bring it forth. Ya Bunay, innaha in taku mithqala habbatin min khardal, fatakun fi sakhra, aw fi samawat, aw fi al-ardi ya'ti biha Allah, inna Allah latifun khabir. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن الكريم، ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
ولينذروا قومهم إذا رجعوا إليهم لعلهم يحذرون.